Welcome back. As promised, we now are joined by Manchester City hero Paul Dickov. Welcome, Paul. Along with him, Pranay Singh, who's the winner of the Sona Mana Hai contest and wins an all-expenses-paid trip to Manchester to watch a Champions League match against Real Madrid. I really envy you a lot, Pranay, but also I'm very happy for you. Tell me about the exact moment when you got to know that you are the one who's going to travel to Manchester.
So during kickoff, Terry pulled up my name amongst the five shortlisted winners. And for a moment, I didn't believe it. I really didn't believe it. But when it was my name, I held it on for 1 second and I was like, okay, wait, it is my name. So thank you, Terry. Thank you, Terry, for that.
No problem.
And did you pray a lot? Because when you got to know that you were shortlisted, did you pray? Did you say, shout out to all the gods possible to send you to Manchester?
Yeah, I kept my fingers crossed since the day I got selected, shortlisted.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Yep, and we're seeing visuals of that moment. This is the defining moment for you, isn't it? Where, and oh, wow, look at that. So you had a little group there watching this. You're a legend amongst them, aren't you now?
Yeah.
How was that? How was that feeling there with your friends?
Yeah, so as soon as we got shortlisted, 8:30 p.m. we checked out, we started watching kickoff. All my friends were around me, and once we started, once the program started and Terry pulled off my name, everyone started celebrating.
Yeah.
And yeah, we partied all night then.
Oh my God, I can see. I only wonder what you're going to do in Manchester then, if you already partied all night knowing that you were the winner of that contest. Yep. Congratulations to you. Paul, I'm going to come to you. And before we get talking about where Manchester City were and where they're headed and where they are, tell me a little something about why you are in India right now, apart from the Champions League.
Yeah, well, Champions League, obviously. And we were in Bangalore last week with Manchester City and their Citizens Giving project. With Xylem, who's their official water partner. And it was a really cool thing to do. You know, we went into schools and explained through football and education the importance of healthy water. But more importantly, you know, there's contaminated water in the schools that the children were using. And with Xylem, we went down there and we built these water towers. And it was just an amazing thing to do. And, you know, Man City and Xylem got to take a lot of credit for doing it. But to see these young children and little kids, the delight on their faces to turn on a tap and see clean water, you know, it's a fantastic initiative, and it's great to be here.
It's incredible that you did this, and Manchester City fans were involved in this as well, in this glorious project that you had.
Yeah, that's always the Citizens Giving itself. They've got over 100 young leaders now in India, but we had five volunteers that came down, you know, from different parts of India. Manchester City fans won the competition and they came and joined us, and everybody had a great time.
That's brilliant, very noble. Now I'm going to bring it back to football, and I'm going to talk about this one particular moment from 1999, because it was set up, I think, perfectly for you, but you really wanted to do this in style, playing in Division 2, the moment for you where you could qualify, trailing, your team's trailing 2-1, and you choose a perfect minute to score a goal, don't you?
Yeah, I did, and I'm still living off the back of that goal 20 years on now. You know, it was a crazy time for the club. You know, that season we'd sunk to the low steps in the club's history.
Yeah.
You know, the club shouldn't have been where they were, but us as players found ourselves all of a sudden 2-0 down at Wembley Stadium in 89 minutes, and we got it back to 2-1 in the 94th minute. You know, I was a lucky boy that managed to score the goal that took us into extra time, and then we won the game in penalties and got back-to-back promotions after that, so it was a special moment for me and still is now.
It's fantastic. Terry, looking at that goal, he says lucky, but that's beautiful. That's one we would love to review here, wouldn't we?
It's the right moment at the right time, and to be fair to Paul, that's put Manchester City now where they are, really, because of that goal. If we look back 20 years ago, if that wouldn't have happened, maybe Manchester City probably might have been where they are, wouldn't have been where they are now. So all thanks to Paul for scoring that goal. And, you know, you look at Manchester City at this present time, you know, fantastic.
Yep, you could say set the ball rolling in those terms. But, Paul, I'm going to come back to you with this. Great visuals there for you to get that qualification, the progressive year, again, making it up to the Premier League as well. But was there any anticipation of where Manchester City would end up just literally a decade later in terms of the heights, in terms of the money that was invested in the club then?
No, not at all. And I think even when the new owners came in 2008, I don't think, you know, we're 10 and a half years, 11 years later on now that we would have expected the Premier League titles that have come in. Competing at the top end of the Champions League, winning FA Cups, winning Carabao Cups in such a short space of time. You know, a lot of clubs don't win that over 30 years, what Manchester City have done, and the owners have got to take huge credit for it. You know, with the signings they've brought in, it really helps, but I don't think they get the credit for instance, the stuff the Citizens Giving stuff, the stuff they do in the community and around Manchester, as you know, Terry. You know, they've completely rejuvenated the whole area around there, creating lots of jobs, and you know, it's not just the difference that they've made on the pitch, the difference they've made off the pitch as well has been huge.
In terms of Pranay now going to Manchester to watch Manchester City playing, tell him how different it's going to be, because when you played, of course, the stadium was not as big. You're talking about the development that happened around the area as well. Not pretty much the same. The scale has just increased so much, hasn't it?
It has. It'll be a lot colder than what you're expecting, for a start. I'll tell you that right now. Bring your umbrella. Yeah. As well, but it's a fantastic place now. You know, the Etihad Stadium, the new training complex, and Manchester is a city. You know, it's a really vibrant place. There'll be loads of fun things for you to do, as I'm sure Terry's going to get onto in a minute. And you'll have a great town. Mancunian people are great. You know, although I'm from Scotland, you know, been in Manchester now since 1995. I feel as if I'm adopted Mancunian myself. My children are all Mancunians as well, and the people are amazing. You'll have a fantastic time. And hopefully celebrating a win against Real Madrid.
Yeah. I like that, like a little bit of an afterthought. Terry, any memories that you guys were talking about back then? Because again, you've been around when it wasn't the City of Manchester Stadium that it is right now. What were the memories back then for you guys?
Well, I think for me, obviously, I played at Main Road. Main Road was fantastic. You come out of the tunnel and you hit the Kippax. The Kippax was like the cop at probably Liverpool. So you hit that and it was probably 15, 20,000 fans in there. It was fantastic times when I was there. Don't forget, Manchester City spent money back then. You know, £2.5 million for myself, £2.5 million for Keith Curl. But there was always a sleeping giant, and it was always somebody to come in and put them where they are now. So I think it's fantastic, to tell the truth. Manchester has grown. It's grown as a place. It's grown. It's nurtured. The nostalgia there is fantastic, you know. You've got loads going on. Yes, 45 minutes down the road, we know there's Liverpool, but Manchester is a hub. It's a fantastic place, and he'll really enjoy himself down there.
He should enjoy himself more in terms of if they get the result that all of you are hoping for and expecting. And, Paul, in terms of that, how do you see this current Manchester City squad?
I think they're amazing. You know, what they've done the last two seasons, I know Liverpool have shot away this year, but you know, to get the 100 points in Centurion season, then to win the domestic treble last year. And you just look at the quality, not in the team, but the quality right throughout the squad that they've got. You know, especially going forward, we can all talk about Kevin De Bruyne, but, you know, Sergio Aguero, Jesus, Raheem Sterling, you know, there's just so much talent going forward all the way throughout the team that at any given time, at any given game, they can go and win. And, you know, I said at the start of the Champions League this year, if City, and it's a big if they can keep their best players fit, they have every chance of going on and winning it, because I would fancy them to beat anybody.
All right, Pranay. Of course, as a fan, you just love going to the stadium. Any player who comes out, you're happy to see them. But any one player who you are really looking forward to watching play?
David Silva, the god, the magician. So I'm very looking forward to watch David Silva play. He's been my idol for at least 10 years since he's joined the club. So I'll be really looking forward to watch him play live.
All right, David Silva, definitely a genius. Terry, are you going to give him some advice, apart from the football, what to do in Manchester?
Well, there's plenty for him to do, you know. There's a lot down there to do in Manchester. You know, we've got wonderful places up there. You can visit the National Football Museum, which is vibrant. You know, you go in there, you'll see everything to do with football, obviously. You know, I mean, there's a million things you can do, but we've just picked a few things here. You know, you can visit the Northern Quarter up there. It's very vibrant. Again, it's a great hub for the younger clientele like yourself. You know, you can take a ride down the Manchester Ship Canal if you want, on a barge. That's fantastic. There's so much you can actually do in Manchester, but there's a few things there what you can actually go ahead, look forward to and all, shopping and all.
Paul? Agree with the list? Want to add something to that list? Any memories that you would like to tell him to make there?
Well, I know there's one on the list there. There's Rushholme, you know, believe it or not, it's a very famous, it's a mile long and it's just full of Indian restaurants and Indian food, Indian supermarkets as well. So when you come over, we'll go and have a curry together.
All right. Well, go there and have Indian food. That would be something to boast about and tell us about it, even though I would be a little envious seeing your updates. I would kind of love to see them. Now, gentlemen, predictions. This is a tough time. Manchester City facing Real Madrid in the first leg. Predictions for that, Paul, first from you?
I'm confident tonight. I do think both teams will score, you know, the attacking threat that Real Madrid have got. But I fancy City to win 3-1 tonight.
3-1. All right, Pranay.
2-1.
2-1?
Yeah. 2-2.
Okay, sorry. I was just making sure. Terry, I'll get your prediction in a little later. You'll be joining me for the next segments as well. Thank you, Paul, for joining us here. Thank you for the noble effort that you have made with the Citizens Project. And Pranay, many congratulations to
you.
Have the best time in Manchester and best of luck to your team.
Thank you.
Well, that's about it, talking about this man here, Pranay and Paul Dickov. We're taking a break on the other side. Of course, we're going to focus on the team that is Juventus that visits Lyon.